Hello students, welcome back to the maths class. In today's class, let us solve problems on the concepts of scalar product or dot product of two vectors. So before actually starting with the problems, I want everyone to once go through the definition and all the observations which I have given for scalar product. Now let's start with the first question of today's class. Let us find the magnitude of two vectors, vector A and vector B. So it is understood that we need to find what is magnitude of vector A and what is magnitude of vector B. This is what they have asked, having the same magnitude. And the other clue given is the magnitude of vector A and vector B are same, means they are equal. And such that the angle between them, okay, is 60 degrees. That is, given that theta is equal to 60 degrees. And the scalar product. What is the scalar product? The scalar product is nothing but the dot product. The dot product between them is 1 by 2. This is the given data. Okay. So let us solve. So we know that the angle between the two vectors is given by cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. Let us start substituting all the values which is given in the data. So cos theta value is known, which is cos 60 degrees, okay, which is equal to vector A dot vector B, which is equal to 1 by 2 whole divided by magnitude of A into magnitude of B. What is cos 60? Cos 60 degree is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 divided by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. What I do is I cross multiply these terms. So when I cross multiply the terms, I get it as magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B is equal to 1 by 2 by 1 by 2, which is equal to 1. So magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B is equal to 1. Now, what is the magnitude of vector A and what is the magnitude of vector B? So here, since they have given that A and B having the same magnitude, we can easily find that, we can easily say this implies that magnitude of vector A is also equal to 1 and even magnitude of vector B is also equal to 1. Next problem, if the vertices A, B and C of a triangle ABC are 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 2 respectively, then find the angle ABC. So we need to find the angle ABC for the given triangle. And they have given which angle? Angle B. So this will be your angle B, this is A, this is C. So we need to find this angle. This angle we need to find. That is the angle between the vector BA and the angle between the vector BC is what we need to find. Then find the angle ABC. Okay, so for that, first let us write the position vectors. They are given A, B and C points, coordinates. Okay, we need to find the position vector. So what will be OA? This is the coordinates of the point A. This is for B and this is for C. So position vector OA is equal to 1i cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Next, what is the position vector of the point B? It is equal to minus 1 I cap. If you want, you can write it as 0 j cap plus 0 k cap. Or you can just write minus 1 j cap. Next, position vector for the point C is OC is equal to, vector OC is equal to 0 I cap plus 1 j cap plus 2 k cap. Actually, we need to find what? The angle between the vector BA and the vector BC. If I call this to be as vector A and this as vector B, that is, if I am calling the vector BA as vector A and the vector BC as vector B, then we can apply the same formula. So in order to find what is actually vector A, we need to find what is the vector B, the vector joining the points B and A. We already know the formula, which is x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 t cap. Or vector BA can also be written as how? It can also be written as vector OA minus vector OB. In our previous classes, I've also told how to write this. This we have got using the concept of vector joining two points. So this is equal to, what is your vector OA? It is 1i cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap minus vector OB, which is equal to minus 1i cap plus 0j cap plus 0k cap. I hope if I simplify it directly, you all understand. 1i cap minus of minus, it is plus. So 1 plus 1, it will be equal to 2i cap. Okay, next 2j cap minus of 0k cap, it will be 2j cap only. Next plus 3k cap minus of 0k cap, it will be plus 3k cap. So we got what is a vector B. Next, let us find what is vector BC. Okay, so vector BC can be written as vector OC minus vector OB. So what is your vector OC? Vector OC is equal to 0i cap plus 1j cap plus 2k cap minus vector OB, which is minus 1i cap plus 0j cap plus 0k cap. Therefore, this is equal to 0 minus of minus plus. So 0 plus 1, it is 1i cap. Next 1. Minus of plus, it is minus. 1 minus 0, it is equal to plus 1j cap. Next 2, this will be minus into plus minus. So 2 minus 0, it is equal to plus 2k cap. So we now found what is a vector BA and what is vector BC. Now let us simplify by applying the formula. So you can even write, let us consider, let vector BA be equal to vector A and let vector BC is equal to vector B. If you want, you can write like this, or else directly also you can use the formula cos theta is equal to, instead of vector A, vector B, you can use this formula, vector B dot vector BC divided by magnitude of vector BA into magnitude of vector BC. Even this you can use. Therefore, cos theta is equal to vector A dot vector B by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B. So what is your vector A? We call BA as vector A. Therefore, this is equal to 2i cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap into that is dot vector BC. Vector BC we have taken, that's vector B. So it is 1i cap plus 1j cap plus 2k cap. Therefore, this is equal to, this divided by root of, hence we need to find magnitude of vector A. 2 square plus 2 square plus 3 square into, now magnitude of vector B, that is 1 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. Therefore, this is equal to, now finding the dot product between these two vectors. How? 2 into 1. So 2 into 1, it is 2. Next, you need to move for J. So unit vector J cap, that is 2 into 1. Again, you get 2. And plus 3 into plus 2, which is equal to 6. Divided by root of 4 plus 4 plus 9. Then root of, it is 1 plus 1 plus 4. Therefore, this is equal to 10 divided by root of, you will get 9 plus 4, it is 13. 13 plus 4, it is 17 into root 6. Therefore, root 17 into root 6, it is 102. Hence, what we need to find actually, only the angle. Therefore, theta is equal to cos inverse of 10 divided by root 102. Understood? Why we are finding vector B and vector BC? Because they have asked us to find the angle. Okay, so here this angle, what is this angle made by BA and BC? This is what we need to find. Next problem, if I cap plus J cap plus K cap, 2i plus 5j and 3i plus 2j minus 3k cap and I cap minus 6j cap minus k cap are position vectors of the points A, B and C, A, B, C and D respectively. Then find the angle between, here they mentioned angle between vector AB and vector CB. Deduce that, this is the first question, that we need to find the angle between these two vectors. The second question is, deduce that vector AB and vector CD are linear. First, let us look up for the first question. So, they have given the position vectors. So, let us write, so position vector of OA is equal to I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and the position vector of the vector B is equal to 2i cap plus 5j cap. Here k component is not given, then it is understood it is 0 k cap. Okay, next vector OC is equal to 3i cap plus 2j cap minus 3k cap, and vector OD is equal to I cap minus 6j cap minus k cap. We need to find the angle between vector AB and vector CD. So let us find what is vector AB. So vector AB can be written as vector OB minus vector OA. So vector OB, it is given by 2i cap plus 5j cap. There is no k component. So for your understanding, when k component or any of the component is not given, you can write it as 0 minus OA, it is I cap plus J cap plus K cap. Therefore, let us simplify, 2I cap minus 1I cap, it is equal to 1I cap. Then, plus 5J cap minus 1J cap, it is equal to plus 4J cap. Then 0 k cap minus k cap, it is equal to minus k cap. Next, we need to find what is vector CD, which is given by vector OD minus vector OC. So this is equal to vector OD, which is I cap minus 6 j cap minus k cap minus vector OC, 3i cap plus 2 j cap minus 3 k cap. Therefore, this is equal to 1i cap minus 3i cap, which is minus 2i cap. Then minus 6j cap, plus and minus or minus, minus 6j cap, minus 2j cap, minus 8k cap. Then minus k cap, this becomes minus and minus plus. So minus k cap plus 3k cap, which will be equal to plus 2k cap. So here what we need to find? We need to find the angle between them. So, cos theta is equal to angle between which vector and which vector? It is vector AB and vector CD. So, vector AB let us treat it as vector A and vector CD let us treat it as vector B. So, instead of writing vector A and vector B, you just replace by vector AB and vector CD respectively. So, this is given by, cos theta is given by magnitude, sorry, vector AB dot vector CD divided by magnitude of vector AB into magnitude of vector C. Therefore, your vector AB is I cap plus 4J cap minus K cap dot, then we have vector C, which is minus 2I cap minus 8J cap plus 2K cap whole divided by, now we need to write the magnitude. So root of magnitude of vector AB, it is 1 square plus 4 square plus minus 1 the whole square into root of finding the magnitude of vector CD, which is minus 2 whole square plus minus 8 whole square plus 2 square. So simplifying further, so it is 1 into minus 2, which is minus 2, then 4 into minus 8, minus 32, then minus 1 into 2, it is minus 2 again, 4 divided by, root of, you have 1 plus 16 plus 1 into root of 4 plus 64 plus 4. So in the numerator, minus 2, minus 32, minus 34, minus 34, minus 2, minus 36. 4 divided by 16 plus 1 plus 1, it is 18, which can be written as root of 9 into 2, therefore which is equal to 3 root 2. Then you have 6 root 2. So here, therefore this is equal to minus 36 divided by, this will be equal to 3 into 6, 18 into 2, root 2 into root 2, it is 2. So you can just cancel it out, 18 into 2 is 36, therefore this is equal to minus 1. Therefore theta is equal to cos inverse of minus 1, or you can even write cos theta is equal to, for what value of cos we will get it as minus 1? It is cos 180 degree. So cos pi. So you will get theta will be now equal to pi. Okay, this is the first part. Now we need to see what is the second part. That is, the second part is deduce that vector AB and vector CD are collinear. I hope you have copied this. So now let us see for the second part. So here in the second part, what I do is, I first consider what is vector CD. So vector CD is given by minus 2i cap minus 8j cap plus 2k cap. We have already seen how to find, how to prove whether the two vectors are collinear. That is, if vector A is equal to lambda times vector B, if you show that, then we say that those two vectors are collinear. We are doing the same pattern here. So I have taken vector CD. From this, I can take minus 2 common. If I take minus 2 common, I get I plus 4j minus k cap. So if you see, I plus 4j minus k cap is nothing but our vector AB. From this, what you can conclude? That these two vectors are collinear, because this is in the form of vector A is equal to lambda times vector B. Hence you can conclude that vector AB and vector CD are collinear. Vector AB and vector CD are collinear. Next problem, for any two vectors, vector A and vector B, we always have magnitude of vector A dot vector B is less than or equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B. This is also called as Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. We need to prove this. So in order to prove this, actually this inequality holds when either vector A or vector B is 0. That is, what I am going to say is, if I take vector A as a 0 vector, then what will be the magnitude of vector A? It is 0. So if magnitude of vector A is 0, this will be 0 into any vector, it will be 0. Then this side, the dot product, if any, when I find the dot product of the vector A into vector B, where A is a 0 vector, then again this will be equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is equal to 0 again. So, when either of A or B is 0, this inequality automatically satisfies. Therefore, this inequality, the inequality holds trivially either when A is equal to 0 or vector B is equal to a 0. So without this, friends, now what we are going to assume is, let us assume that they are not 0. That is, not vector A is also not equal to 0. That is, magnitude of vector A is not 0. That is nothing but vector A is not a 0 vector, and even vector B is also not a 0 vector. Therefore, their magnitude will be automatically what? It is not equal to 0. So under this condition, what happens? So what I do is, I consider the angle between the two vectors, which is given by vector A dot vector B by magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B. Let us apply the magnitude for the entire formula. So this will be magnitude of cos theta is equal to magnitude of vector A dot magnitude of vector B by magnitude of vector A dot B by magnitude of vector A. When you again apply magnitude over magnitude, it's just the same. So here also magnitude of vector B. So we all know that the range of cos theta is from minus 1 to plus 1. So when you apply a magnitude over minus 1 to 1, that is the range of cos theta is from minus 1 to 1. So when I apply magnitude for this range, all the negative values, when we apply a magnitude, it will be positive 1. Therefore, this modulus, okay? So this will be equal to, this can also be written as vector A dot vector B by magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B is equal to cos theta. So this actually it will be minus 1 to 1. Therefore, since we have applied the magnitude, it will be always positive. Therefore, what happens? This implies that vector A dot vector B by magnitude of vector A into magnitude of vector B will be always less than or equal to 1. Why? Because the range of cos theta is from minus 1 to 1. Since we have taken the magnitude, this will be less than or equal to 1. Therefore, when you cross multiply this, we get magnitude of vector A dot vector B will be less than or equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B. Okay, this is about Cauchy Square's inequality. Now, next, moving to triangle inequality. Okay, here I have given that there are two vectors, vector A and vector B, and they are telling that it will be always magnitude of vector A plus magnitude plus vector B, that is magnitude of vector A plus vector B will be less than or equal to magnitude of A plus magnitude of B. Let us prove this. So in order to prove this, I consider magnitude of vector A plus vector B the whole square. So when I consider whole square, I can write this as vector A plus vector B dot vector A plus vector B. Why we can write this? Because when I was explaining you the observations of scalar product, there we have got vector A dot vector A, we have written as magnitude of vector A the whole square. We are using the same observation here. So magnitude of vector A square can also be written as vector A dot vector A. With this concept, we are writing vector A plus, that is magnitude of vector A plus vector B, the whole square can be written as vector A plus vector B dot vector A plus vector B. So, finding the dot product, what you should do is A dot A. So, vector A dot vector A, this with this, then again this with this, vector A dot vector A, then plus, then you have vector A dot vector B. Now, this with this term, plus, plus into plus, it is plus. Next it is vector B dot vector A. Then this with this term, plus into plus, it is plus. Next you have vector B dot vector B. Okay, so what is vector A dot vector A? It is magnitude of vector A the whole square. Plus A vector A dot vector B plus, this can also be written as vector A dot vector B. Why? Because we have already seen that the scalar product is commutative. Because of the commutative property, vector A dot B is same as vector B dot A. Plus, vector B dot vector B is magnitude of vector B the whole square. So this can be written as magnitude of vector A the whole square plus 2 times vector A dot B plus magnitude of vector B the whole square. Okay, next. This is actually less than or equal to magnitude of vector A the whole square plus 2 times you have magnitude of vector A dot vector B plus magnitude of vector A the whole square. Why? Because for any real number x, okay, x will be always less than or equal to modulus of x. Okay, so for any real number x will be less than, if you take minus 5 is actually less than or equal to modulus of 1 is 5. With that we can say that magnitude of vector A the whole square plus 2 times the magnitude of vector A dot vector B plus magnitude of vector B the whole square is less than or equal to this one. Next, this is less than or equal to magnitude of vector A the whole square. From our previous problem, we can write magnitude of vector A dot B is less than or equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B. I am using this. So, 2 times, this can be written as magnitude of A into magnitude of B plus magnitude of B the whole square. Now, if you see, this is in the form of A square plus B square plus 2AB. So this can be written as A plus B the whole square. So here the value of A is magnitude of A and the value of B is magnitude of B. So this magnitude of A plus magnitude of B the whole square. Okay. So therefore I can write vector magnitude of vector A plus B the whole square is less than or equal to magnitude of A, magnitude of B the whole square. Hence, magnitude of vector A plus B is less than or equal to magnitude of A plus magnitude of B. Okay, in this, if the same inequality holds, then what we have done is, we have taken a triangle A, B and C, and we have applied triangular law. This is vector A, vector B. This is A plus B. We have told that the magnitude of vector A plus B is less than or equal to magnitude of vector A plus magnitude of vector B. If the inequality, if the equality holds in this condition, when we are taking only the equality, then we can write it as vector magnitude of vector A plus magnitude of vector B. Okay, under this condition, what I can write is, what is vector A plus B? It is nothing but magnitude of vector AC. Vector A plus vector B is vector AC. We have taken magnitude, so magnitude of vector AC, which is equal to, what is magnitude of vector A? It is magnitude of vector AB and magnitude of vector B, which is magnitude of vector B. This tells us that the points A, B, C are collinear. Under what condition? Under the condition of equality. Under the condition of equality, we can say that A, B, C are collinear. Next problem, show that the points A, B and C are collinear. So till now, you know, when we are going for collinear, we used to use the formula vector A is equal to lambda times vector B. That is, given two vectors, we can easily find, when the two vectors are given, we can apply this formula. That is vector A, that is one of the vectors is lambda times the other vector, if we prove, then it is collinear. If it is given for three vectors, how to prove it is collinear? We have just seen how to prove collinear. We have just found the formula in triangular inequality. So, according to that, if A, B and C, the points A, B and C are collinear, this implies that vector AC is equal to vector, magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. Okay, so when we need to prove that the three points are collinear, what we need to do is magnitude of vector AC is equal to magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. So even include this in your observation, and this is also important trick formula, important formula. So with this formula, that is fine. So they have given what is vector OA, which is minus 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap, and next vector OB, which is I plus 2j plus 3k cap, and we have vector OC, which is 7i cap minus k cap. So let us first find what is vector AC. So vector AC is given by vector OC minus vector OA, which is equal to vector OC, which is 7i minus k. It is understood j is not there, therefore j is 0j cap minus k cap minus vector OA minus 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap. Okay, therefore this is equal to now 7i plus 2i, which is 9i cap. Then we have 0 minus 3, which is minus 3j cap. Then minus k cap minus 5k cap minus 6k cap. Next, let us find what is vector AC. We found, next let us find what is vector AB. Okay, so vector AB is equal to vector OB minus vector OA, where vector OB is equal to I plus 2J plus 3K cap minus vector OA, which is minus 2I plus 3J plus 5K cap. Therefore, this is equal to I minus into minus plus. So 1 plus 2i, which is equal to 3i. Next you have 2j minus 3j. 2j minus 3j, it is equal to minus j cap. Then 3k cap minus 5k cap, which is minus 2k cap. Next, let us find BC. See, if you know the formula, you can easily check. So first identify AC vector, then vector AB, then vector BC. So vector BC is vector OC minus vector OB. Therefore, vector OC, which is 7i cap plus 0j cap minus k cap minus OB I plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Therefore, 7i cap minus I cap, which is 6i cap, 0j cap minus 2j cap minus 2j cap, minus k cap minus 3k cap minus 4k cap. Okay, so once we have found the vectors, what we need its magnitude. So let us find magnitude. So what is the magnitude of vector AC? This is given by root of, that is 9 square, then plus minus 3 the whole square, plus minus 6 the whole square. So this is equal to 81 plus 9 plus 36. So 81 plus 9, it is 90. 90 plus 36, it is 126, root 126. This is equal to root 126. So root 126 can be written as 3 root 14. Why? Because root 126 is nothing but root of 9 into 14, where this can be written as root 9 into root 14. Root 9 is nothing but 3, so 3 root 14. Next, let us find what is the magnitude of vector AB, which is equal to root of, so this will be 3 square plus minus 1 the whole square plus minus 2 the whole square, which is equal to root of 9 plus 1 plus 4, which is root 14. Next, we need to find what is the magnitude of vector BC, which is equal to root of, you have first 6, So 6 square, then what do you have? Minus 2 whole square, then we have minus 4 plus minus 4 the whole square. So this is equal to root of 36 plus 4 plus 16. So 36 plus 4 plus 16, it is 40, 56, root 56. Where root 56, if we simplify, we get it as 2 root 14. Now actually what we need to prove? We need to prove that. So let us see whether magnitude of vector AC is equal to magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. So I'm going to conclude it here. So what is magnitude of vector AC? Should be equal to magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. Magnitude of vector AB is what? Root 14. Magnitude of vector BC is what? 2 root 14. What is root 14 plus 2 root 14? It is equal to 3 root 14. And we also got that magnitude of vector AC is also 3 root 14. So we can conclude that the given 3 points ABC are collinear. Next question. Similar question you have, same question. Only the numericals are changed here. We need to prove that the points ABC are collinear. So here they have not mentioned in position vector form. So let us first write it in the position vector. So what is the position vector? OE, which is equal to 1i cap plus 2j cap plus 7k cap. And the position vector OB is equal to 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 3k cap. And position vector OC is equal to 3i cap plus 10j cap minus 1k cap. So here what we need to find, we are using the same formula. So I want everyone to write the formula whenever you are solving the problem, whichever formula included in that particular problem, better keep writing that, that will be a practice for you. So this is the formula which we are going to use. So first we need to find what? Vector AC, which is vector OC minus vector OA. So it is 3i cap plus 10j cap minus 1k cap minus 1i cap plus 2j cap plus 7k cap. So this will be equal to 3 minus 1, 2i cap, next 10 minus 2, which is plus 8j cap minus 1 minus 7 minus 8k cap. Next, we need to find what is vector what? Vector AB. So this is equal to vector OB minus vector OA. Therefore, vector OB is what here? It is 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 3k cap minus vector OA. 1i cap plus 2j cap plus 7k cap. So simplifying, 2 minus 1, it is 1i cap, 6 minus 2 plus 4j cap, 3 minus 7 minus 4k cap. Next, we need to find what is vector BC. This is vector OC minus vector OB. So vector OC given by 3i cap plus 10j cap minus 1k cap minus vector OB, which is 2i cap plus 6j cap plus 3k cap. So this is equal to 3 minus 2, it is 1i cap, 10 minus 6 plus 4j cap minus 1 minus 3 minus 4k cap. What is our next step to be done? It is, we need to find their magnitude. So magnitude of vector AB is equal to root of, so first let us find AC itself. So magnitude of vector AC is equal to root of 2 square plus 8 square plus minus 8 the whole square. So this is equal to 2 square 4 plus 8 square 64 plus 64. So this is equal to, if you simplify this, we get it as root 132. So when you simplify again root 132, this will be equal to 2 root 33. Let us find what is magnitude of vector AB, which is root of 1 square plus 4 square plus minus 4 the whole square. So this is equal to 1 plus 16 plus 16. So it is 20, 30, 2, 33, root 33. Next you have magnitude of vector BC, which is equal to root of, again 1 square plus 4 square plus minus 4 the whole square. So this will also be equal to 1 plus 16 plus 16, which is root 33. We need to prove that formula. So that is magnitude of vector AC should be equal to magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. So what is your magnitude of vector AB? Which is root 33. And also magnitude of vector BC, it is root 33. So root 33 plus root 33, 2 root 33, which is same as the magnitude of vector AC. So this is how we solve the problems for collinear. That when they ask us to prove that the given three points are collinear, we use the formula magnitude of vector AC is equal to magnitude of vector AB plus magnitude of vector BC. So let us end this problem for today's class. In the next class, let us solve few more problems.